Welcome back to Rotation. It is your boy Zary Highlife, and I'm gonna be honest with you, the last 2 months have not been the best for you boy. Like, I was starting to get consistent at dropping content, you know. I was feeling motivated, feeling good, and then I got hit with a throat injury, put me out for some weeks, and then I was back to it, you know. Same, my throat got healed up, and then another throat infection. So now I have figured out I could not smoke flower, you know, or pens, or I'm not smoking at all until I get my tonsils out, because apparently my body does not fuck with my tonsils. Keep infecting them because they want them out. I'm like, all right, we get it. Let me get the surgery. Today, I really want to talk to y'all about how I've been getting high lately. Today, I want to be breaking down 3 edibles that I've been eating recently. Now, if you are from Michigan, then you may have seen this brand. I'll be honest with you. The edible is kicking in as we speak. We will be talking about Fwaygo. Fwaygo, I got introduced to via carts. Fwaygo, drop it. So I don't know if you guys are aware, but in Michigan, there, and I'm pretty sure they sell them some other places now, but there is a brand of pop. I'll call it pop, not soda. There's a brand of pop called Fwaygo that I love. You grew up in Detroit, you grew up on Fwaygo. Fwaygo grape, Fwaygo. All right, relax.
I beg your pardon.
Fwaygo orange, some of my favorites, the grape one. Ohana is also a Fwaygo, or not Fwaygo, Fwaygo. Subsidiary. I will be breaking down 3 Fwaygo edibles that I've tried this week and tell you my experiences with them and how I like them and if you should get them. So I'm gonna just stop holding them up 3 at a time. I've been trying edibles. I've tried the because I'm not a fan of edibles. I don't know if you guys know me, but bongs are my favorite way to smoke weed. I love bongs. I just love the architecture of bongs. That's why I love Daily High Club so much. And I do apologize because I had a Daily High Club video to make, but I was waiting on the package, and when the package got delivered, I was in Michigan in the hospital in October. So like this last time, I was in the hospital again when the package got delivered, and I'm pretty sure they sent a bong, and if they did, I can't smoke out of it, but I will show you. So Daily High Club, if you're watching this, I do apologize. Also, my Twitter got suspended, so I kind of just disappeared, but you guys can follow me on my new Twitter account, Zary High Life. I love the name. It's anywho. So I've been trying various edibles for weeks now, and I've been getting used to edible highs. I'm still not a fan. You have to wait for it to kick in, and you know, sometimes you might think you're sober and then you might do another one. You're out getting high again, and there's like, oh no, now you're double high. I'm gonna explain that later in this video. But so I will be talking about those other edibles I've had on the channel. I'll eat them when, you know what I'm saying, I got y'all. The one I had, the fruity pedible, was really good. And I had the brownie from Michigan Fudge Company that also slapped. So I'll talk about those in the future. Once again, Fwaygo. So we're gonna start off. First, I had the frozen cherry slushy Fwaygo gummy. So I'll show you here, right here. This is indica dominant, by the way. 10 milligrams each. I'm gonna be honest with you. I am not an indica fan. My body just reacts to indica weirdly. I don't know, like I get strong indica reactions more than, like, that's why do you think I am sativa's favorite son? I fucking love sativa strains. Animal cookie is my favorite strain. Like, I enjoy indica, don't get me wrong, but my preferred will be sativa. And indica gummies, I've noticed I've had some pretty bad experiences. So this one, my first time eating it, I was feeling pretty good, just relaxed, just chilling, really. Like, it was a real vibey high, I'm not gonna lie to you. I only had one. I'm good off of one. And you may think that's, you know, 10 milligrams. Listen, I'm fine, I'm good. I have learned my limits. So off of one, I was feeling pretty cool and relaxed. Now, a few days later, I went back to this again, cause you know, I'm getting used to them. Like, oh, before I got this one, I was eating I was using Dixie gummies too. The they're citrus sativa based gummies. Those are fucking incredible. If you see in your dispensary that they have Dixie gummies, I'll show a picture of me on the screen with the, I don't remember what the package looks like because it was last week, but so Dixie gummies go hard. They were a sativa base, but this one was indica. So a few nights ago, I was in Discord with a homie, and we were fucking around talking. We were planning a new project ahead, and I was like, you know what? Yeah, man, I'm gonna just take a fucking boom. Take one of these, whatever. I'm feeling good. I thought I got sober again, so I was gonna take another one. I took another one, and two of the gummies, like, I'm pretty sure I was still high, but I thought I wasn't. Like, you know those highs where you, like, you come down for a little bit, and you get back up there? I guess when I took this next one, my body was like, oh no, don't. That's, So, as the second edible kicked in, I was even higher, and I got to an uncomfortable high. And like, for those, I don't know who here has experienced this, but sometimes when you get a little bit too high, you start getting a little panicky, shaky. You're really aware of your surroundings. But for me, I was aware of my surroundings, but it felt like I was not supposed to be. Like, I felt like I was in a simulation. I'm staying right now. It just looked weird as fuck. Like, it looked the same, but I was like, man, I feel like I'm being watched. Or like, it was weird. And my stomach wasn't like, it kind of made me nauseous a little bit. Like, my stomach just kind of felt funny. I felt like I had just like a water balloon of just water and shit, and my stomach just like going around. So my whole brain kind of just set to, hey, don't throw up. That is it. Like, literally just don't throw up. I fucking hate throwing up with everything in me. Like, I genuinely cannot. I would do everything in my power to not throw up if I have to. And I was like on the couch, just like focused on like one thing at a time, because my stomach, like you know in WWE 2K games where you do the chain wrestling and you use your analog to find the red and then the red has to expand, I felt like if I move a little bit, where's the blue, red, and just stay in that, I stay in the same exact position for like 10, like if I look uncomfortable, I'm not moving. So when Sai got home, she was like, oh hey, how are you doing? I was like, hi, I'm pretty high right now. And like, I wasn't too scary high where I needed her to like hold me, because that has happened before off the fruity petable where she had to hold me. And like, because I'm gonna tell that story, boy, that was a night. So I just really focused on feeling really, like, just trying to not feel as sick as I was. And like, I started coming back too mentally. Like, sometimes you'll just be out of it. Like, you don't know where you are, but then you can start having actual conversations. I was at that point, but I still felt really sick. So that's what the indica one did to me, mainly because I didn't go to sleep. I don't know if y'all know, but you should probably go to sleep. If you're feeling like your body says, hey, I want to lay down and go to sleep, you should probably do it. Don't fight that off, or you will end up like me, having fucking wild ass highs and fucking panicking and paranoid and shit. That's that, like, no, just take your ass to bed. But a few nights later, I received two new Fwaygo gummies, and the next one I'll be talking about is orange popsicle, and that was a sativa dominant. So when I heard it was a sativa dominant gummy, I got, yeah, my bad, Stuart. But yeah, so when I took this one the first time, I instantly did not like the flavor. Though I do not like creamsicles, like orange creamsicles, I fucking hate those. They make my stomach hurt. I don't like it at all. No. But the high I was getting off of it was pretty good though. Like, I was chilling. I don't remember what I was doing the first time I ate this one. I'm pretty sure I was like just chilling around the house, just seeing how I feel, and then talk about the project in Discord a little bit. I ended up going on a walk. That's what it was. The walk I went on off of this. I went on a sativa stroll, and I was feeling really good. Like, the thing I like to do the most when I'm high is go on walks, because I enjoy nature. I love going outside, and you just start, like, experiencing, like, shit. Like, shit just happens when you're outside high. Like, not bad shit, obviously. Like, I'm talking, like, just funny shit or, like, random, like, you just see random shit happen. So like, as I'm walking down the street, I mean, nothing random happened this time, but it just feels like I'm in GTA online, minus the fucking everybody just, you know, the GTA, maybe like Skyrim, just life simulator, let's say, just the Sims. It doesn't doesn't really feel like The Sims, though. It just feels like GTA minus the chaos. That's what it really feels like. But no, The Sims feels weird. I'm talking like literal, like presentation-wise. Your eyeballs, like your thoughts will like you will, like if you have a GPS, you will feel like the GPS in GTA. You know, I don't know. Maybe I'm just creative and I like to have fun. Okay, these I don't like. I'm not a fan of this one. Like taste-wise, high-wise. I mean, you know what I'm saying? It's cool. I was vibing a little bit. I think it leaned with the creative was like, I was like thinking of shit on my walk. I was trying to piece together things to talk about in the project, but that's just, I don't know. I got to try it sitting down because walking, you know, you kind of go in and out of the highs. You got to be focused, you know what I'm saying? You got to be aware of your surroundings. But next, my motherfucking favorite one out of the three so far, bro. The Hulk Sour Apple Gummy, bruh. This shit tastes so good. And I'm high as fuck off of it right now. This is like the high I'm feeling right now. Hello, Fwaygo Extracts. Hulk Sour Apple. It tastes immaculate. The first time I took this one was, I think yesterday. Yesterday, I pretty much went on a walk. I went to go get a chili dog. Pretty cool experience. I did experience the vibey the orange one. I forgot to mention this one. I know for sure how you're gonna get off of this one. Every song I was listening to, I felt like was made with a golden microphone. The vibey effect. So you will have hella euphoria and like the happiness effects off of this one, because I was walking, but a nigga wanted to dance down the street, and I was not about to do that. I do that when I'm on skates. Good feeling off of this one. The song that like stuck out to me on that walk, I fucking listened to goddamn Victory Over the Sun by Biffy Clyro. That's a bro, they went stupid on that song. So to pretty much rank these, I'd say this was Hulk Sour Apple is my favorite. Highly recommend. If you are a orange creamsicle fan, because apparently those exist. Me and my mom do not like these. I was gonna give these to her, but I told her the flavor and she was like, no, get that shit out of here. Like, all right. But orange, like these, these are my least favorite. The cherry had a good taste to it. Tasted like fucking it tasted like a fruit snack. And I'm gonna be honest with you, fruit snacks make my stomach hurt. So I don't know. If you want more edible reviews like these, then let me know in the comments down below. Once again, I highly recommend Fwaygo Extract. Shout out to them if they want to work with your boy. You feel me? yeah. I will follow me on Twitter because I no longer have my X3 account. I have Zeri High Life. So you make sure you follow me on Twitter. That's where all you will see. That's where I am the most active. So like I tweet a lot. I update y'all on the content, where I'm at, what I'm doing, what I'm smoking. You get funny tweets, you get tweets of my new tattoos, like bold and brash, you feel me? More like belongs in the trash. And then you can't see the last time. It's fine. But until then, that's all I got for today's video. Until then, take it sleazy, and I'm out. See you, dude.